Interesting findings support the hypothesis that trigeminal afferents control the activity and trophic state of the locus coeruleus noradrenergic neurons, with potential implications in neurodegenerative disease treatment. Locus coeruleus noradrenergic neurons have been implicated in early stages of neurodegenerative processes. On the other hand, trigeminal signals strongly influence the LC activity, and their impairment may trigger neurodegeneration in animals. Molar teeth extraction has been observed to induce the degeneration of trigeminal afferents, locus coeruleus, and hippocampus, leading to behavioral impairment in animal models. In otherwise healthy humans, the occlusion asymmetry due to teeth loss or to abnormal dental contacts is associated to a left-to-right asymmetry of the masseter electromyographic activity during clenching and to a pupil size asymmetry, also called anisocoria, which represents a proxy of the locus coeruleus imbalance. The occlusal asymmetry can be corrected using a bite splint, as shown in the figure. This has been demonstrated to reduce the asymmetry of masseter electromyographic activity, the anisocoria thrust, to enhance cognitive performance in task-related mydriasis. As we have previously demonstrated, correcting the masseter EMG asymmetry and the anisocoria using a bite splint enhances cognitive performance in subjects free of neurological disorders. Here we report an anecdotal evidence from a patient diagnosed with multiple sclerosis, who underwent occlusal rebalancing according to dental prescriptions. At the baseline acquisition, an abnormal gait was observed, due to a clear foot drop. Using a bite splint, the occlusal balance was restored. The patient was requested to perform the same working test after wearing it for 4 weeks, and clear improvement was detected. Occlusal rebalancing could promote significant clinical improvements in patients affected by neurodegenerative disorders, but these observations require a carefully designed clinical trial to be confirmed. We look forward to seeing you at the Lancet Summit 2021 to discuss this topic with you in more detail.